Hi everyone, my name is Jagbir Singh. I'm Director of Preclinical Development Services at PNI. Okay, so in this presentation, I will be focusing on key concepts and key considerations when taking an RNA LNP vaccine program from discovery to late stage preclinical stage. And towards the end, I will also present a recent data from our novel lipid compositions that are being used in the development of a novel COVID vaccine. So first question is why the mRNA LNP tech? Again, the case in point here is the speed at which we were able to go from availability of viral genome info to first injection in humans. So again, mRNA LNP is a platform technology that really provides a rapid response time in an outbreak. In addition, RNA vaccines are safe, cost-effective, and provide flexibility to target various infectious pathogens, as it can encode any antigen. Few of you may know that PNI has also received funding from Canadian government to develop a COVID vaccine. Although both Moderna and Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine use conventional classical mRNA technology for in vivo expression of viral antigens, we chose to focus on developing self-amplifying RNA for expression of antigen. So the key advantage of the self-amplifying RNA is that a single strand of self-amplifying RNA can make multiple copies of antigenic mRNA sequence itself. So this means a very low amount of RNA will be needed to produce a high antigen expression. For example, like for comparison, again, conventional mRNA needs 30 to 100 microgram of dose per person. In case of self-amplifying RNA, we'll need about less than 3 microgram of dose to produce similar response. So this again lowers the amount of formulated materials needed to vaccinate the population, lowers the cost, and significantly improve our response time to an outbreak. So again, currently lipid nanoparticle-based delivery system is the most advanced and proven technology for RNA delivery. Typically, a multi-lipid composition is used as each lipid offers different structural and functional attributes to the nanoparticles. Lipid nanoparticles, they mimic low-density lipoprotein particles, which allow them to be taken up by the cells. And ionizable lipids are considered kind of the most important lipid in the composition as it helps in encapsulation protection of RNA and also helps in endosomal escape once inside the cells. Here, we jotted down few selection criteria to help in the selection of novel lipids for development of RNA LNPs vaccine. Most often, we do see that research groups focus on select few properties by neglecting others until late in the development stage. So this again affects project budgets, timelines, and if potential issues are not identified early in the program. So broadly, we classified the lipid selection criteria in three buckets: the properties that can impact your ability to produce nanoparticles, properties that can influence the biological performance, and some key considerations in lipid synthesis itself. For good nanoparticle formulation, it requires good solubility and stability of your lipids in both organic solvents and aqueous buffers. PK is another important characteristic. Make sure that we are not only determining the PK of the lipid, ionizable lipid, but also the lipid mix itself. So again, based on literature, a PK between 6.2 to 6.7 is found to be optimum for performance. Stability is another area to focus as soon as suitable analytical methods are developed. On the synthesis side, we will say pay attention to synthetic scheme, such as how many steps in synthesis, does the synthesis process introduce any impurities or contaminants that may affect the product quality. So these are good questions to ask early in the development program itself. When it comes time for formulation development, again, during this stage, it is important to identify and understand critical quality attributes. A critical quality attribute is a property of your nanoparticle formulation that impacts quality, safety, and efficacy of your product. For example, is variation in particle size having a significant impact on your product performance? How about lipid to RNA ratio? Higher lipid to RNA ratio may be better for product stability, but too high can cause toxicity or may interfere with RNA release or expression inside the cells. So although I would say like in the literature, like in last two decades, there is a lot of literature there. It provides guidance on critical quality attributes, but remember each LNP formulation is unique. Similarly, the choice of processing method can impact these critical quality attributes. Therefore, it is important to determine critical processing parameters so that effective control strategies can be developed when scaling the formulation from milliliter to liter scales. Few examples are downstream processes can be impact of in-process, hold time, mixing conditions such as flow rate, dilution scheme, temperature, the stability of your product at like the room temperature versus refrigerator conditions and etc. Again, for both critical quality attributes and critical process parameters, a quality of design statistical approach is preferable to single factor design studies. Again, I will emphasize, make sure we have established reliable biases so that you can look at the potency impact of these attributes, particle characteristics on biases, and also the analytical method. It can help with your both formulation and process development. Here, again, a summary of some information that may be needed when performing a tech transfer from discovery to preclinical stage. In addition to developing protocols for formulation, downstream processing, biases, and analyticals, we suggest to start collecting initial stability results as soon as possible. This can help you troubleshoot many potential issues early in the program itself. Another consideration should be given to draft a target product profile early in development program. This document lists desired characteristics and features and can become a guiding document to help determine the data set needed to demonstrate your product's performance, efficacy, and safety. So here is the recent data from two of our lead lipid compositions, which are being used for delivery of self-amplifying RNA that encodes for SARS-CoV-2 spike protein. So here in this study, self-amplifying RNA LNPs were prepared using our nanoassembler technology, and they were transfecting in HEK293 cells. And protein expression was analyzed using ELISA. So both formulations, LNP formulations, showed excellent transfection in vitro assay. So based on this encouraging results, we tested our formulations in vivo. So for in vivo studies, mice were vaccinated twice, 4 weeks apart with a dose of 1 microgram self-amplifying RNA LNPs. And at 3 weeks, we collected serum and evaluated IgG response against the SARS-CoV-2 spike protein and tested its activity in a neutralization assay against the coronavirus. At termination point, spleens were extracted and spleen cells were also stimulated against SARS-CoV-2 peptides to test cellular immune responses. In summary, if you can see my pointer, both LNP formulations produced high IgG responses at a dose of 1 microgram. And both these, the antibodies from the sera showed that it will be effective in producing protection against this coronavirus as determined in the neutralization assay for the graph on my right. In a separate study by our collaborators at Imperial College of London, one of our lead formulations were tested at different doses for delivery of siRNA. And here also, we observed high IgG response, even at a low, as low as like 0.01 microgram dose. Formulations were effective in a neutralization assay, and spleen cells showed cytokine responses when exposed to SARS-CoV peptide. Finally, I would also like to highlight that more than 4,000 medical conditions are a result of gene disorders. So therefore, our ability to manipulate, edit, and introduce new genes holds key to developing effective treatment options in the future. Having said that, developing genetic medicine is still challenging because of lack of widespread availability of tools, knowledge, and experience with this emerging technology. So as a PNI customer, you will have access to our proprietary microfluidic manufacturing platform, a panel of proprietary lipids and lipid composition for your RNA encapsulation and delivery. And most importantly, a team of experts who can share their experience and help in development of your product from discovery to clinical stage. Again, thank you for listening and happy to answer your question during Q&A session. Next, I will hand over the presentation to my colleague and teammate, Dr. Adam Crowe. Thank you.